Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone, and welcome. Right. My name is Xhelili. I'm from Comscore, and I am joined today by the lovely Dan MacDonnell from Channel 4 to discuss digital, social, and measuring audiences and content cross-platform, wherever they are. Dan, welcome. It's a pleasure to be here with you today.
Thanks so much.
Tell us a little bit more about Full Studio and what your role entails.
Yeah, so I'm Dan MacDonnell. I'm a strategist within our creative solutions team at Channel 4. So what that means is we partner with brands to make content that lives across the Channel 4 ecosystem. So streaming, YouTube, social, we're making bespoke shows for brands. My background is actually in sort of analytics and planning. So I not only work on the kind of brief response side of things, but also on the measurement side as well. So that's looking at sort of the quantitative side of things, working on platform analytics, but also with Comscore, and also on the qualitative side of things, so on sort of research and measurement as well.
Wonderful. Well, we'll be talking today about the intersection of digital and social. At Comscore, we are a measurement partner for online audiences, for media. We work with lots of publishers, with brands, with agencies, to really help bring to life what the digital and the social landscape is. And in order to do that, we've got a bunch of data sets in hand. These include a global human panel, it includes social data feeds of the social giants. And what we were able to do is, and I think this is where synergy exists between Channel 4 and Comscore, is that you guys put viewers at the heart of all decision making, and Comscore likewise places audiences and viewers at the heart of all of our measurement solutions. So, and the reason why we wanted to say, hey, looking at the intersection of digital and social, why that's important, the reason why is, well, we've got some big numbers behind us just to help put that into context, but when we look at the time spent online in the last 12 months, we as a UK society have spent 61 billion hours online. And within that, we can see that CTV is catching up with social, which is big. And then entertainment also takes a big chunk of the time that we're spending online, right? So entertainment is fair to say is at the heart of the British society. And needless to say, Channel 4 play a key role in driving that joy, that enthusiasm for really good British content. Now, having said all that, earlier this year, you announced your Fast Forward strategy with a core mission of making Channel 4 a digital-first public service streamer by 2030. Dan, what does this strategy entail? Tell us a little bit more.
Yeah, absolutely. So, Ira alluded to it, that social and digital are a huge part of our Fast Forward strategy going forward. I mean, we were the first broadcaster to launch a VOD platform back in 2006, I think, which is like 18 years ago now.
Wow.
Obviously, our VOD platform has evolved and grown over time, not least gone through a few name changes. But as I say, it's gone from strength to strength, sort of growing through and since the pandemic. And then when it comes to social, I think social is a massive priority for us. It's all about sort of following the eyeballs, making sure that our strategies are audience first, and we're sort of present in all of the places that audiences are watching content. One of our big goals as part of our Fast Forward strategy is to double views on social by 2030, and we're well on our way to doing that. Things like our long-form episode strategy, which I'll talk about a bit more later on, launching things like Channel 4.0, which is our first YouTube first channel, and also with things like the stuff that my team does in terms of social branded entertainment and making kind of bespoke branded shows that live on social.
That's wonderful. So when we look at these stats, you'll see that there's a really good mix of platforms where consumers are consuming content, right? So you've got CTV, you've got social. There's a collision for attention, right, with where audiences are spending their time on whatever platform they're on. With that in mind, what does the Channel 4 viewer look like with regards to where do they spend their time, which platforms do you find them on, and what are some of those shifts that you have seen?
Yeah, absolutely. I think tailoring your platform strategy is key to any strategist, I suppose. Following the eyeballs, as I've spoken about already, and yeah, I alluded to it. Connected TV is growing massively. I think anybody who's worked in YouTube for the last few years knows that it's a huge growth area. But that's not to say that short form isn't equally as important. When we look at sort of those short form mobile driven platforms like Instagram Reels, like TikTok, we see them being huge drivers of reach and engagement. They're not just a shop window into Channel 4 either. I think what's really important to note is that some people are only engaging with the broadcaster through those kind of social formats. And so one thing that I always think about whenever I'm planning campaigns is not just to think of those platforms as cut downs of longer form content. They're very much about bespoke sort of assets that can stand alone and make sense on their own. We actually launched a product called Four Shorts about a year and a half ago now, which is an opportunity for brands to partner with us when it comes to short form only. It's sort of a lower investment, lower entry point, very high engagement, very high reaching product that you can work with us on. And we've seen huge success over the last few months with some of our campaigns that really drive huge engagement and huge reach. But as Ira says, it's really important to kind of think about audiences wherever they're watching. Like maybe it's sort of them being on the bus wanting to watch videos of Matt Hancock being shouted out by SAS staff, or maybe it's people kind of leaning back watching full episodes of Gogglebox on their Xbox. And that kind of comes into everything we do when we're planning our campaigns.
Right. One thing that we saw in the stats was that time on digital exceeds time spent on TV. And that's big. And when I think of CTV, I think that CTV is a love child of TV and digital. Mm-hmm. And we've seen some huge growth from CTV coming from Channel 4. And also when it comes to CTV, one thing that has caught our eye is your growth on your YouTube channels watched through a CTV device. So we did an analysis. We've got some really cool data when it comes to YouTube that we can collect here at Comscore. And one thing that stood out for us for Channel 4 is that the increase in time spent from January to April shoots up like this for all Channel 4 audiences. So tell us a little bit more about the success story behind that. Is it related to the generational shift of audiences from TV to your platforms?
Yeah, I think one thing that we always keep in mind is TV is absolutely not dead. I think there's always going to be a place for TV for that, those sort of prestige moments, the intergenerational viewing, those live moments as well. But absolutely, you've alluded to it, that audience habits are changing. Younger people want to kind of consume content on YouTube where they can choose what they want to watch at all times. And so we're keeping up with that. I mentioned before that we've started publishing some of our long-form episodes in full on YouTube to great success, and that's part of the reason that we've seen huge growth, I think, through connected TV. Right. You know, we're uploading Gogglebox, location, 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 grand designs to YouTube in full now. And as you say, like, we've seen massive growth. I think this year alone, we've seen 92% growth in those full episode viewing, and a big part of that comes from connected TV as people sort of lean back and settle into their evenings.
That's right. So definitely.
Yeah,
so January to April was an increase of 190%, and that's phenomenal. That's a really good story to tell around your growth on CTV. So, and it also lines really well with your strategy to be able to do that generation, to be able to meet the audiences where they are, right? So putting the viewer at the heart of decision making. So talking about YouTube, which we've talked about a fair bit today, one thing that we notice is that YouTube wears the crown when it comes to the reach amongst different generations. So we've got a look here at Gen Z, we can see millennials, we can see Gen X. So it's pretty much at the top of every single chart. But one thing that stands out on the chart, and hopefully I'm not in the way of it, one thing that stands out here is the story around Gen Z. As you can see, there is a collision for attention there where TikTok is nearly meeting the reach of Instagram, and you've also got X and Facebook on equal footing. So there's a collision for attention there, and then you've got everyone who will try to get into that race to get that, you know, to command their attention for Gen Z. So with all of these differences, you know, you've got Gen X, then you've got millennials, you've got the differences that are quite more distinct. So we've got some distinct preferences there, but particularly on Gen Z, we can see that there's a race there. Now, with all of these differences that we've got here on the screen, as we can see when it comes to social media adoption, how do you navigate all of these preferences and all of these changes that each and every single generation demands? How do you keep up with it?
Yeah, it's probably the first thing I think of when I'm sort of responding to a brief, like thinking about the different platform strategies we implement. I'll give you some examples. So one campaign that we're actually launching today for co-op funeral care, which doesn't sound like the most Channel 4 exciting kind of social brand. It's actually one of the campaigns I'm most excited about. It's just to give you a little flavor of it. It's sort of Don't Tell the Bride-esque in that we're getting celebrity couples, one of them to kind of plan the other one's funeral. Our first one today is coming out with Bez and Sean Ryder from the Happy Monday, so you can imagine how much carnage and chaos that is. But when I was sort of planning that campaign out, it's obviously targeted at over 45s. We're thinking about kind of YouTube and Facebook as being our primary platforms, and the sort of the creative is built out from there. Whereas when we're thinking about planning something like the campaign we did for Elf, the makeup brand, last year, that was very much focused at kind of Gen Z 16 to 24s. And so naturally, like TikTok, Instagram, but also YouTube are key priorities for us there. One thing that I always think about when I look at graphs like this is how ubiquitous YouTube is across the board. You know, you're seeing almost 90% for all three generations. So we always think about YouTube whenever we're planning a campaign because it's such a great driver of watch time for us, but also there's so much presence from all audiences. One thing I would say, though, is it's not as simple as saying young equals TikTok, old equals Facebook. You look at that, the Gen X's on TikTok is 37%. While that doesn't sound like the biggest number in the world, that's not an insignificant number at all. And I think there is a place for kind of content that targets older people to live on TikTok. I would be very surprised if that 37% number in a year's time hasn't increased significantly. So yeah, as I say, it's not as simple as just saying young equals Instagram and TikTok, old equals Facebook.
That's right. So when it comes to, you know, you're able to see all of these big numbers on the screen, what position do you take at Channel 4 when it comes to standing out against large, giant entertainment conglomerates and social media giants as well? How do you stand out in such a crowded space?
Yeah, I think innovating and evolving is part of Channel 4's DNA. One example of that is, I think four years ago now, we launched a digital commissioning division. So they were set up to specifically commission shows for YouTube, so digital originals that were YouTube first, but also lived across our other social platforms. So we've got in a load of social experts who have kind of worked in TV in the past, so they can create those sort of heartland, broadcast quality, premium Channel 4 shows, but really targeted at that kind of YouTube and social first audience. We've created, you know, like risque documentaries, sort of social first comedy series to great success. In 2022, we actually won a BAFTA for one of our digital originals, which is called How to Be a Person. Really would encourage you to check it out. It's absolutely brilliant. It's about how kind of young people navigate all the complexities of modern life. We also won Broadcast Channel of the Year for Channel 4.0, which we'll talk about in a minute, which was our first ever YouTube first channel. That we launched that kind of bridges the gap between creator culture and our premium offering. And then that's sort of where my team comes into it. So within social branded entertainment, what we offer is brands to have access to our digital commissioning team. So the people responding to your briefs will be the same people who are commissioning kind of our award-winning digital originals. So it's really, really fun working with kind of those digital commissioners who are at the top of their game producing these amazing shows. And within social branded entertainment, we're sort of commissioning branded shows that we'd be happy to commission ourselves without brand involvement. So please do come and speak to me afterwards if that's something you'd be interested in. I can tell you about it a bit more.
Yeah, wonderful. Well, some recent work of yours that has caught the attention of audiences on social media include your work with Tesco, which plays around with We Are Lady Parts with a series. There's your work with John Lewis, which I always find to be quite witty. It's always humorous to see all those moments, yeah. You know, people moving homes. And a personal favorite is, I mean, who doesn't love a dog, right? So it's Pet Plan. So all of your work with Pet Plan also gets really good engagements. What are some of your favorite projects that you've worked on with brands when it comes to sponsorships?
Yeah, I think there are so many to choose on. I've worked on so many amazing campaigns. Co-op's an example. I've worked on a brilliant one for Vinted, Tourism Ireland, Philips. But we've picked out two here that I absolutely loved, and the kind of results spoke for themselves. So to start with, we were briefed by Lego, I think at the back end of 2022. And it was all around this brand platform of theirs, which was about celebrating the imaginations and creativity of kids, and how it's really kids' imaginations and creativity that are going to help us solve the world's problems in the future. And we sort of came to it thinking about how we could really make that feel very Channel 4, but also have the brand at the forefront of the content. So what we came up with was a show where we paired this kind of cutest, smartest kids with some like heartland Channel 4 talent. So people like Rhys James, Judy Love. And basically what we did, we sat them in a room, gave them a load of Lego, and we briefed the kids with the goal of creating an invention and building it in Lego that was going to help solve the world's problems in the future. And you can see, like, we executed it with some amazing Lego animations. I think it was our most engaged campaign ever. It's just really funny. I think anything with kids always does amazingly well. But by pairing it with some of our, like, best talent, it had brilliant results. So, again, I encourage you to check that out on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, all the above. Then we've got this campaign for Warner Brothers Studio Tour, which, again, we did, I think, back end of 2022. Basically, Warner Brothers Studio Tour came to us with the goal of encouraging people who weren't just Harry Potter super fans to come and visit their studio tour in Watford. Very much focused on sort of that 16 to 34 bracket. And we went back to them with a campaign idea built around 4.0, which is the property I'm going to talk about in a minute. Very much built around kind of creator culture. We challenged two creators, one who's a Harry Potter super fan, one who didn't know too much about Harry Potter at all, to go to the Warner Brothers Studio Tour and try and be tour guides for the day. Again, what this did was tap into something that I think is very Channel 4, which is that sort of raucous, energetic, chaotic kind of content that really we're finding, like, Gen Z in particular absolutely love. The results, again, were absolutely brilliant. Really high engagement rates. I think our record watch times ever, but also more importantly, had real impact for the studio tour, seeing visitors increase over that period. So, yeah, two examples of different campaigns. Hopefully you can see that they're quite different briefs and they sort of have different goals, but both equally successful in their own right.
And after I've seen these reels, I now know that Wizkid is a Nigerian rapper, and he's not Wizard Kid, which is Harry Potter, so I've learned something new. I am not Gen Z, as you can clearly see. But before you go to the Harry Potter studios, which you haven't been yet, I've been told.
I haven't been.
You haven't been. You're going somewhere else this summer. You've got different plans. Where is the summer leading you?
Yeah, absolutely. So I think the Paralympics is always a real highlight of every 4 years at Channel 4. And this year's no different. So this year we are televising every moment of live sport and putting it on YouTube. So we're going to have 18 concurrent live streams. And I think it's over 1,300 hours of live sport this year, living all on YouTube, which is a broadcaster first for us. I think every year we see the Paralympics grow and grow, and as I say, this year is no different. So I'm actually going this year, so I'm going to the Para Taekwondo, which I'm very excited for. I even tried wheelchair rugby out last week, so we're really in Paralympics fever this year.
Fun.
And I suppose by putting all of the content on YouTube, also having loads of cutdowns living on Instagram and TikTok, I think what we're really trying to do is follow the eyeballs. We know that we've got our kind of core audience on TV, but we're also kind of adding that incremental reach of social and YouTube as well. And I think Comscore and seeing your kind of cross-platform incremental reach tools will help us kind of understand the true reach of the Paralympics this year.
Absolutely. So the Paralympics is going to be the most social one yet. And growing in power, we've got Gen Z, and the Channel 4 sports audiences will be taking center stage with the Paralympics this year. It's going to be the summer of sports, right? So we've got the ability at Comscore to not only do things like rankings or demographic profiling, but go into some of those more tactical things that you can do when you are working, you know, when you're having those discussions with brands. So things like affinity scores always stand up to publishers because they can show off their audiences in a way that brings a natural affinity to the brands you're having those discussions with. So we actually played around with some of the data a little bit, and we can see here how the Gen Z audiences who sit on your channel for sports YouTube channel, what their affinities are. So they show really high affinity to the entertainment brands. And something that's here that doesn't surprise you whatsoever is your high affinity with Vinted, right? So you've already got projects with Vinted, you've worked with them in the past, and that also meets our narrative that Gen Z always score a lot higher than the other generations when it comes to things like sustainability, green living, the engagements are a lot higher. And then on the other side of the screen, we've got Gen X, so the Gen X Channel 4 sports audiences. If I could picture that, if I could paint a picture of that, it would be a someone purchasing a home, IKEA shopping, John Lewis shopping, and then just celebrating housewarming party with Uber Eats, right? So it's a varied audience, and I think it just dives into the message of not all audiences are the same, not all audiences are equal, and that we need to be able to tailor and to cater to all of the audiences. Now, let's move on to the fun stuff, or the fun audiences. So we've talked about Gen Z quite a bit today. When I think Gen Z and the home of Gen Z, I think Channel 4.0. So when I think Channel 4.0, I think Gen Z, youthful culture, a bit of chaos, playfulness, and also influencers and content creators that really know how to fuse premium British content with that feel-good entertainment. What's that success behind Channel 4.0?
Yeah. You've sold it even better than I ever could, I think. I think, yeah.
Sign me up.
Yeah, so Channel 4.0 came from a place where we saw an opportunity to sort of bridge the gap between UK creator culture, which is very much at the heart of everything that kind of youth audiences consume on social, with our kind of premium broadcast capabilities. So we launched Channel 4.0 in, I think, November 2022, and it's gone from strength to strength. I think the success really lies in speaking to that generation authentically. So we're really leaning into the talent that they all engage with. So people like Nella Rose, Chunks, Philly. But as I say, kind of leaning into our credentials as Channel 4 of creating these shows that people love to watch and creating these formats that are really engaging. It's been incredibly successful. As I mentioned before, we won Broadcast Channel of the Year in 2023. But I think the graph I really love is this. People talk about the fact that Gen Z have tiniest attention spans, but we've really bucked the trend with Channel 4.0. We're seeing on some of our shows like 9, 10 minute plus average watch times for kind of 80% 18 to 34 audiences. So it's really bucked the trend in that sense, right. I think, and shows that YouTube, mid-form and long-form really is still a place for kind of Gen Z and youth audiences to play into. It's not just about those 3-second views on TikTok, even though it is about those as well.
Well, it's a really good example of how Channel 4 are leading the charge when it comes to understanding and engaging with social audiences. And it's actually a prime example of how Comscore think about what measurements should look like. So with Channel 4.0, it lives on YouTube, but then it's also got huge engagements on TikTok, right, on all of these other huge platforms. If you got back to the start of our chat today, we saw that your audiences, they live everywhere. They're streaming content on CTV, digital, TV, then they go and they visit your PC, the laptops or the mobile app sites. So there's lots of like little media touch points that people go to when they are consuming, when they are streaming content. So it becomes even more important then to be able to analyze the demographics, the engagements, and be able to tailor content to the audiences in whatever platform they may be. And that's pretty much the premise of Total Digital and Social Incremental, which we've got here at Comscore, which has got the ability to unify digital and social audiences under one single roof, be able to break out audiences, whatever platform they may be, but also be able to bring an overarching number of deduplicated total reach. When it comes to your discussions with brands and advertisers, what are the most important discussions that you have when it comes to measurement?
Yeah, I think that's totally it. I think trust is like the trust that we have in TV is moving over to digital now, and I think people are trusting our kind of social and digital numbers even more. And it's crucial for all of our campaigns to be able to measure that cross-platform reach. And that's where something like Comscore comes into it. Previously, we were not able to deduplicate across YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, and so on. And so where Comscore comes into it is being able to do that kind of deduplication and cross-platform measurement. So it's really crucial to everything we do now.
That's wonderful. That's all we've got time for today. Thank you so much, Dan, and thank you, everyone, for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Take care.
Thank you.